Hello everyone, today we'll be doing the remaining problems of exercise 9.1 of chapter number 9, which is some applications of trigonometry. The question number from where we are starting is question number 7. From a point on the ground, the angles of elevation of the bottom and the top of a transmission tower fixed at the top of a 20 meter high building are 45 degree and 60 degree respectively. Find the height of the tower. So a figure is drawn here, of which this is taken as the building, this is the transmission tower above it, and the building's height is given to be 20 meters. And what they are saying is, from a point on the ground, the angle of elevation to the top of the top of the tower and the bottom of the tower is given. That is, the angle of elevation of the bottom is 45 degree and angle of elevation of the top is given to be 60 degree respectively. That means from bottom, when you draw like this, join like this to the point, that will be 45 degree, bottom 45 degree, and from the top when you are drawing, this will be your 60 degree. Okay, so both the angle of elevations have been marked. And your purpose is to find out what is the height of the transmission tower. So for that, since we don't know this distance from the point to the foot of the building, we are taking it to be x, then this as h, that is the height of the tower is taken as h. So that we can consider two triangles here, two right triangles you can see. One is CAB with this angle as 45 and the other one is DAB, which is having the angle as 60 degree. Okay, from these two concepts, we will be able to find out what is h. So from the first one, we will first find out what is x, and then we will move on to the second triangle, the bigger triangle. Again, we can use this side and this side in order to get what is the value of h. Okay, so let's start. Let BC be the building and CD be the tower, transmission tower. Okay, then you will have angle DAB is equal to 60 degree and angle CAB is equal to 45 degree, and let AB is equal to x meters and CD is equal to h meters. And what is given us, BC is equal to 20 meters. These things we have. Okay. So we are just starting from triangle CAB. Again, CAB is also right angled at B. So we are just using the trigonometric ratio. Which trigonometric ratio will be suitable here? We have to first check. That is, for this triangle, I have to consider this side, which is already known to us, and we need to find out this one. So this and this included means opposite and adjacent are included. So you can start with tan of the angle. What is the angle there? 45 degree. So tan 45 degree is equal to opposite side, which is BC by AB. What is BC taken as? BC is 20 and AB is x. Now what is the value of tan 45? It is 1. Tan 45 degree is 1, so it is 20 by x, which will give you what is x is equal to. So you are getting x is equal to 20 meters. So you got the distance from the point on the ground to the foot of the building. Now we will move on to the second triangle where h is included. Okay, in the triangle, what is the bigger triangle? DAB. Again, you have to include this side so that this h is included, and this side. So for this triangle, this is the opposite side and this is the adjacent side. So again, we will start with tan of that, that is tan of 60 degree, which is equal to opposite side, which is BD by AB. Now what will be BD? You just see BD is BC plus CD, and this is 20, this is h, so that BD is 20 plus h and AB is x. Okay, now what is tan 60 degree root 3? Root 3 is equal to 20 plus h by what you got your x to be? 20 meters, so it is divided by 20. Now cross multiplying, you'll get 20 root 3 is equal to 20 plus h, or h is equal to 20 root 3 minus 20, or 20 into root 3 minus 1. Therefore, what is h? Height of the tower. Therefore, the height of the tower is 20 into root 3 minus 1 meters. Okay. Question number 8 is, a statue 1.6 meter tall stands on the top of a pedestal. From a point on the ground, the angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degree, and from the same point, the angle of elevation of the top of the pedestal is 45 degree. Find the height of the pedestal. So again, the figure is drawn here. This is taken as, that is, BC is taken as pedestal, CD is the statue, and from the, just see, from the top of the statue, the angle of elevation is 60 degree to the point. So this is the point taken, that is, from the foot of the pedestal to the point. This is taken as the point, and here you have the angle of elevation as 60 degree, that is, to the top of the statue, and from the top of the pedestal, that will be actually bottom of the statue also. So from the top of the pedestal, you are getting the angle of elevation to be 45 degrees. Okay, and this distance from the point to the bottom of the pedestal or foot of the pedestal is taken as x meters, and the height is taken as h. Okay, now we can start, and again we have to find out the height of the pedestal here, h. Okay, so first let BC, which is the height of the pedestal, be height of the pedestal, which is BC, is equal to h meters. Then what you are taking, okay, statue, height of the statue is CD, which is equal to 1.6 meters given, and we are taking the distance between the point and the bottom of the pedestal. Okay, this is given, this is let the distance between the point on the ground and the foot of the pedestal be x meters. Okay, now we can see two triangles. One is DBA and the other one is CBA, both right angled HB. So we can use trigonometric ratios there also. Okay, so first we are considering the smaller triangle, which is CBA or ABC. There you will get, again we will consider this side and this side because this is unknown in both the cases. So we are just including opposite side and adjacent side, so that it is tan 45 degree. Opposite by adjacent is tan. So tan 45 degree is equal to h by x, or you can say BC by AB, which is h by x, and tan 45 is 1. So you're getting 1 is equal to h by x, which will give you x is equal to h. Okay, so let it be there for later use. Now we are considering, okay, this is in triangle, the other triangle, in right triangle, this is also right triangle. For all the cases, it will be right triangle, then only we can apply the trigonometric ratios. Okay, and in right triangle, we are taking the bigger one, which is DBA. What we can again choose, in order to include h, we have to take this side and this one, because already we have got this in terms of h, so that we can replace it and make it an equation in h only. Okay, so again we are considering tan, because it will consider your opposite side as well as the adjacent side. So opposite side is BD by AB. Now what is BD? 1.6 plus h by AB is x. Now again x can be replaced with h, and what is the value of tan 60 degree, which is root 3, is equal to 1.6 plus h by h. Now cross multiplying, you will get root 3h is equal to 1.6 plus h, or this will give you root 3h minus h is equal to 1.6, or you can take out h in common, which will give you inside as a remaining thing as root 3 minus 1 is equal to 1.6. That means h is equal to 1.6 by root 3 minus 1. Again, in order to avoid this term in the denominator, that is rationalizing, what we will get is 1.6 by root 3 minus 1 into root 3 plus 1. We are dividing and multiplying with its conjugate, that is root 3 plus 1, denominator's conjugate. So that the denominator will become, what will happen to denominator? It is 1.6 into root 3 plus 1 in the numerator, and denominator will be a plus b into a minus b, will give you root 3 the whole square minus 1 square, right? Root 3 the whole square minus 1 square will give you 3 minus 1, which is 2 in the denominator. So it is 1.6 into root 3 plus 1 by 2. Now this can be cancelled and you will get 0.8 here. That means the total answer is 0.8 into root 3 plus 1 meters. What is that? That is h. That means height of the pedestal. Okay. Therefore, height of the pedestal is equal to 0.8 into root 3 plus 1 meters. Okay. Question number 9 is, the angle of elevation of the top of a building from the foot of the tower is 30 degrees and the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from the foot of the building is 60 degrees. If the tower is 50 meter high, find the height of the building. So the figure is very important. If you are able to draw the figure, then the remaining things will be very easy. So what is given here? Two things, that is a building and a tower. So this is taken as a building AB and the tower as CD. And what they are saying is angle of elevation of the building from the foot of the tower is given to be 30 degrees and the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from the bottom or foot of the building is given to be 60 degrees. Okay, and you have to find out the height of the building. So let's start with, so we can here also consider two triangles, which is your this one right angle triangle and this right angle triangle, that is ABD and CDB. Okay, from these two facts you can find out what is the unknown thing. Now we'll start with what is given the height of the tower is equal to 50 meters and let the height of the building be, which is AB, is equal to h meters. Okay, now this h is our unknown, which has to be found out. Now we are considering right triangle. First we will consider this, by because here 50 is known and we can find out BD, because this BD is common to both the triangles. So first we will find out what is BD from this triangle, where one is known, and we will find out this value. Then we will start with this triangle in which this is unknown and this will be known from the first fact, and you can find out what is h. Okay, so in right triangle CDB, again CDB, the angle of elevation is 60 degrees, so you will have opposite side by adjacent side, that is tan 60 degree is equal to CD by BD. CD is 50, BD is not known to us. If you want, you can just replace it with a variable also. Now what is tan 60 degree? Tan 60 is root 3, so you are getting root 3 is equal to 50 by BD, or BD is equal to 50 by root 3. So this is the length of BD in meters. Now we'll go for the other triangle, which is in right triangle ABD, which is right angled at B. Now there you can again choose your tan, because this is opposite by adjacent. Adjacent is also known for us now. So it is tan 30 degree is equal to, opposite is AB, AB by BD. What is AB taken as? It is H. And what is BD? BD, you got it to be 50 by root 3, right? So that now tan 30 degree is 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3 is equal to h by 50 by root 3. This y root 3 will go up and it will become h root 3 by 50. Now from this, what is h is equal to? This will come down. 50 will go there. So 50 in the numerator and in the denominator, root 3 into root 3, which will become 3. So 50 by 3 is your h. And this can be made in the mixed fraction as 16 2 by 3. So this is your height of the building. Therefore, height of the building is 16 2 by 3 meters. Okay. Question number 10 is, two poles of equal heights are standing opposite each other on either side of the road, which is 80 meter wide. From a point between them on the road, the angles of elevation of the top of the poles are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. Find the heights of the poles and the distance of the point from the pole. So you have two poles, suppose AB and CD are two poles. They are in the opposite direction of each other and this is the road. Okay, on either side of the road you have poles, so this is the road which is 80 meter long, and there is a point on the road from where the angle of elevation is given. From a point between them on the road, the angle of elevation of the two poles from the top of them are given as 60 and 30 respectively. Now the thing is, you are wherever you are taking the point, nearby that will be 60 degree, and which is, I mean, from this pole which is far away, that will be having angle of elevation as 30 degree. Okay, so that much okay. Now we are just taking, we have to find out two things here, two things in the sense, because these two heights are equal, only one h, one variable h can be considered for both the things, and then distance of the point from the poles, that is these two distances also you need. So if this total is 80 and if I'm taking one of the distance as x, the other one will be 80 minus x, or else you can take it as some other variable and then do the problem also. Okay, this much is clear. Now we can start the problem. Let the length of the, sorry, height of the pole, height of the poles be h meters, and what we are taking is one of the distances be x, or let the distances of the point from the poles be, let the distances of the point from the poles be x and 80 minus x respectively, as shown this figure. Okay. Now we are starting the problem, that is we are considering the triangles. Two triangles we have to consider. First I'll consider CDO, which is right angle at D. Okay, in triangle, right triangle CDO, this O is taken as that point. Okay, the point which they are referring in the question. So from CDO what you will get? Again we have to consider this side and this side taken into consideration will give you tan of that angle, which is 60. Is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So it is h by x. And what is tan 60? It is a root 3, which is equal to h by x. Or you can say that h is equal to x root 3. Let this be here. Okay, h is equal to x root 3. Let it be here. Now we will move on to the next triangle, which is triangle ABO, right angled at B. Here again we are considering tan of the angle, that is tan 30 degree. Again you can have opposite side by adjacent side, which is h by 80 minus x, which will give you again tan 30 degree is 1 by root 3 is equal to h by 80 minus x. Or from here what you will get h as, h is equal to 80 minus x by root 3. So you just see from both the things you are getting h equal to, that means, and we have the concept that both the poles have the same height, that is both are same h. So that from these two equation, from 1 and 2, you will get, since the left hand side are h equal, right hand side will also be equal. That means x root 3 will be same as 80 minus x by root 3. Now from this we can find out what is the value of x. Okay, now cross multiplying, what you will get? It will become x into root 3 into root 3. Root 3 into root 3 is 3x. 3 into x is equal to 80 minus x, or 3x plus this will come here as positive x, so that it becomes 4x is equal to 80, or x is equal to 80 by 4, which will give you x as 20. Okay, 20 meters. Now we have to find out what is the other thing, that is 80 minus x. So what will be 80 minus x? 80 minus x is the remaining, that means this distance. This distance is 20, means total is 80. So this will you will get as 80 minus x, so that it is your 80 minus 20, which will give you 60 meters. So at last we will just write the distances are like. Okay, now what you need? H. Now what will be H here? You can just replace in any of the equations the value which you got. Okay, so if I'm replacing in first one, therefore from one, or one becomes H is equal to x root 3, that will become what is x? 20. So 20 root 3 is H. Therefore height of the poles is equal to 20 root 3 meters. Then distances of the point from the poles respectively are 20 and 60 meters. 20 meter and 60 meters. Okay. Question number 11 is, a TV tower stands vertically on a bank of a canal. From a point on the other bank directly opposite the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 60 degree. From another point 20 meter away from this point. So this is TV tower, this is the bank. So at one end of the canal, that is, you will have two banks. This is the canal, BC is the canal. So this width you have to find out, and this tower is standing on one of the banks. They are saying that the another bank, that is other bank, that is your C, point C, and from there the angle of elevation is given to be 60 degrees. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 60 degree from the other bank, which is opposite to the tower. Okay, so this is the point. Then from another point which is 20 meter away from this point, that means this bank, the other bank, you are having another angle of elevation which is 30 degree to the same top of the TV tower. Now you have to find out the height of the tower, that is this much, and the width of the canal. So I am taking the width of the canal. This is the canal, okay, BC. This is canal. So canal width is taken to be x meters, and TV tower's height is taken as h meters. Now you have to find out both the things. So we will consider again two triangles. One is ABC and ABD. Okay. So what is given and what is to be taken? Let the height of the tower be h meters, and the width of the canal be x meters. Now we'll consider right triangle ABC, which is right angle at B. What we are taking, again you have to include this and this, so that we are taking tan 60 degree, which is equal to h by x. Now what is tan 60 degree? This is root 3. So we are getting root 3 is equal to h by x, or h is equal to x root 3. Okay, now moving to on to the next right triangle, which is ABD. Again we are considering tan, because opposite by adjacent we have to take. So tan 30 degree is equal to h by, this is your BD, that is BD means that is the total length of the adjacent side. So BD can be written as this is 20, this is x, so it is 20 plus x. Okay. Now what is tan 30 degree? It is 1 by root 3 equal to h by 20 plus x. So from here also we will find out h and then equate them. So this will give you h as 20 plus x by root 3. So from 1 and 2 both are h is equal to. So from 1 and 2 what you will get is 20 plus x by root 3 is equal to x root 3. So this will go there. What it will have it as 20 plus x is equal to x into root 3, which is 3x. So that you are getting 2x is equal to 20, or x is equal to 20 by 2, which is 10. So x you got as 10 meters. Now what will be h? H is equal to, therefore h will be x root 3. That means you are getting 10 root 3 meters as h. So these are the two things which you have to find out. That is height of the tower. Therefore the height of the tower is 10 root 3 meters and width of the canal is 10 meters. Okay.